Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop Podcast. So, it's the beginning of the month, and that can only mean one thing. It's time for Router Bit of the Month. That's right. Once again, the great folks over at Woodcraft and the Whiteside Machine Company totally set us up. Not only did I get to try one of these great router bits, but more importantly, they sent me a second one to make sure that one of you lucky listeners gets a chance to have one also. So, what do we have this month? Well, for the entire month of January, Woodcraft is featuring Whiteside Machine Company's 90-degree Vee Groove cutting bit. And this is a great little profile. Really, when it comes down to it, I think a lot of people assume, I mean, when you look at that one, the first thing that comes to your mind is sign making, but you know what? There's a few other things that we can do with this, and we'll explain it in just one second. Now remember, every single month, Woodcraft picks one of the many, many profiles that Whiteside Machine Company makes. And what they do is they put a nice little discounted price on it to make it very easy for the rest of us to kind of pick up some of the profiles that maybe we like, you know, look at them like, it's nice, but I don't know if I can afford that. Well, you know what? With the discounted price that Woodcraft puts on these, it's very easy to get your hands on these without breaking the bank. So, like I said, for the entire month of January, Woodcraft is featuring this. So if you're lucky enough to have a Woodcraft store near you, well, you know what? Head on over there and take advantage of the great discounted price. But if you don't and you're interested in picking up one, well, you know what? I'll make sure I have links so that you can get them online also. So you can easily head over to woodcraft.com to pick one of these up. So anyways, though, let's talk a little bit more about the actual 90-degree V-groove cutting bit. So this is a quarter-inch shank bit, obviously. I mean, look how narrow that bit, the shank is. It's about 2 inches in overall length. And really, the cutting diameter of this is about half an inch. Now, the point length is actually, which would be from the point down to where the body actually grabs a hold of the cutter itself, that's about a quarter inch. So that refers to how deep it can actually go without having to worry about, you know, basically hitting the body. Now, of course, as always, Whiteside Machine Company, all the router bits that we've been trying out here are carbide tipped, and this one's no exception. I mean, look at that. That's, again, a nice, thick piece of carbide. Whiteside Machine Company does not skimp on their carbide tipping. But anyway, so look at this. This is a essentially a two-flute cutter. So in other words, you've got the two bevels. There's one. There's the other one, which means that you're going to get nice, really smooth, clean cuts from this. And the one thing I really like about this design is the fact that, well, when you look at it, it kind of has an arrowhead shape, doesn't it? I mean, really, when it comes down to it, it kind of goes up to a point and everything. And what I like about this, what I refer to as a rather open design, is the fact that it's going to clear the chips and the dust away really, really quickly. It's not going to heat up as much as some other designs. In fact, one that I have from an earlier set that I actually purchased, to me, it's kind of like a glorified countersink is what it really is. This one, though, because of the open design of it, like I said, it's not going to heat up and it's going to spit those chips and that dust out of the way really, really quickly. So you'll really get a chance to see what you're working on. Now, the one thing is, of course, since it's carbide tipped, that means the fact that, number one, it's going to be a while before we have to worry about sharpenings, unless, of course, you're really abusing the living daylights out of these things. And, you know, you could be like hitting stone with it. I don't know. You can do whatever to abuse these things. But anyway, since it's carbide tipped, it's going to be a while before you have to sharpen it. But when it comes down time to actually sharpen it, well, you know what? Because of the size of this, you're going to get a lot of sharpenings out of it. So you're going to definitely be set for a while. It's really worth making the investment in a really great bit like the ones that Whiteside Machine Company makes. So now that we know a little bit about the router bit, let's talk about what it is we can actually do with it. So let's talk first about the family of the grooving profiles. Okay, so what exactly is a grooving profile bit? Well, just like the name suggests, it actually helps you to cut grooves. Now, where can you use this? You might be familiar with some decorative features like fluting, and let's see, you could also be referring to what's called like veining, essentially. It's essentially another name for fluting. But let me show you something. Now, we're all familiar with this bit, right? I mean, this is a chamfering bit. And so you would use this on an edge profile. I mean, obviously, you've got the bearing up here, and you would actually bump it up against it, and it gives you a nice little 45 degree. Well, essentially, the grooving bit is also essentially kind of a chamfering. But the big difference is, you couldn't really run this in the very center of it. I mean, obviously, the bearing's going to get in the way. So if you wanted to have, let's say, a channel for, like, fluting, you couldn't really use your chamfering bit, obviously. Like I said, the bearing's in the way. That's where a grooving bit comes in, and you could use it for making a decorative feature, such as grooving around the perimeter of the face of a board. You could use it for fluting, and grooving profiles come in just about every type of profile that's out there. Obviously, if you look at this, the V-groove one, It's very similar to the chamfer bit. They both are at a 45 degree angle in this situation. There are also grooving bits that have just a simple round over on the top. There are ones with classical profiles, OGs, etc. So really what it comes down to it is, like I said, you want to put some fluting in there or a groove or something. That's where you would use the grooving bit. Now, what I want to do next is we're actually going to demonstrate what I think are like the three main things we can do with the 90 degree Vee Groove bit. And the first one, of course, that comes to mind is sign making. So what we're going to do is, unfortunately, I don't have a template system where I can make really, really the technical letters and numbers and everything. So I'm going to do mine freehand just to demonstrate it. But basically, I think that's where most people really kind of associate the Vee Groove bit with. I'm sure all of us have seen those great wooden signs. We probably even own ones like, you know, it'd be like the Vanderlust family, where we've got Matt, Sam, and blah, 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 blah. And so, you know, Addison and Aiden. And let's see, then of course, you know, there's all sorts of, like, you could do it for your address and everything. So the first thing I'm going to do is we're going to head over to the workbench, and I'm actually going to show you my freehanding of just a basic stencil. Okay, so obviously I don't work this fast. I wish I could. But really the main idea is that once you get the router bit in place, make sure that you push firmly down on the surface with the router and you'll be able to control it and you'll get really decent results. With the template, probably a lot better than what I'm doing here, but you know, it still works all the same. Okay, so that was really, really easy when it came down to it. The nice thing about it is the fact that, like I said, the Vee Grooving bit actually, it clears the chips and the sawdust out of a way so there wasn't a lot of friction. It was easy to control, and when it came down to it, it was a really smooth action. Of course, I was a little bumpy myself when I was using the router, but that's just me. So if you are to actually ever do that freehand, or even if you are using a template system, take extra precaution to make sure that you got a good grip on the actual router itself. And once again, here's what we actually did. As you can see, I mean, it really kind of highlights it and kind of, well, you can't really feel it, but essentially it just gives it a nice depth so that, let's say I were to actually maybe color this in with, say, black or who knows, maybe even like some gold leafing or something, it would really make it stand out quite well. Now, the next thing I want to do is I want to take the Vee Grooving bit and we're actually going to do some fluting with it, and I'm going to demonstrate that in 1 second. Of course, we can also easily, you can refer to it as veining, grooving, whatever you want to. But I'm gonna show you two examples of what we can do with the groove bit on just the inside of a board, other than doing some lettering.
Really, when it comes down to it, the veining is just like with the lettering itself. You get yourself a decent template, or in this case, I used my fence, although it didn't quite work as well as I wanted to. And again, I don't really work this fast. It would be great if I could. I get a lot of projects done. But you get the idea. Have a starting point and a stopping point.
Alright, well, really, it's really basic and simple to kind of do some fluting, and here's what we actually did. Of course, if your fence on your router would work a little bit more cooperative than mine did. But essentially, you still get the idea. It gives you a nice little dramatic flair here that just kind of draws your eyes to it. And you know what? This is used quite a bit in like colonial style moldings, various pieces along that line. Essentially, really what it comes down to it, the deeper the groove itself, it'll get a little bit wider up here. You can, you know, vary the width. You can have fewer, you can have more, but essentially it really looks good. Now, one other idea along the line of the grooving, I want to show you actually a picture of a side for a desk that I did for my wife. Essentially, she just wanted something just to kind of, you know, dress up what was going to be an ordinary kind of plain looking table leg. So I'm gonna show you that picture real quick, and then I want to come back and show you one more idea that I have for using the Vee Groove cutting bit. Alright, so as you can see, really when it comes down to it, we could easily use the Vee Grooving bit to actually kind of like, you know, put a decorative pattern onto the face of a board, much like we would use for when we're using it for sign making. Now, the other idea I was thinking of is, if you remember back when we had the tongue and groove bit, one thing I was talking about was if we just use the tongue and groove by itself, you really kind of get just of a plain looking board. Now, that's great if you're trying to use the tongue and groove to make a wider board or a wider panel much more stable, but let's say you're like, you know, putting it together for, let's say, the back of a bench or something, and you want to add a decorative feature to it. Well, you could easily do like a double chamfer like this, and you know, it kind of pulls your eyes into it and gives it a nice little dramatic flair. Now, one problem is when you go to actually put that chamfer on it, when it comes to the grooved side, it's really easy. Basically, grab your chamfer bit and mount it into your router table, or just do it freehand, and you can see how it just kind of goes along and easily gets in there and gives you the chamfer you want because there's nothing blocking it. Try that with the tongue side, and you can see you're going to run into problems. The tongue is way too extended, the chamfer can't get in there, and it's not going to work. So what can you do? Well, one option, of course, is to grab our block plane and try and get that angle and make sure that you get it exactly 45 degrees. And if it's off a little bit, well, you know what? It's custom furniture, so what are you going to complain about? Or you could grab your Vee Groove cutting bit, set up the fence on your router table, and you can easily get in there and more or less kind of go along and get that chamfer effect, because remember, this particular bit, the 90 degree V cutting bit, essentially both sides work to be about 45 degrees, which is similar to our 45 degree chamfer bit. So you can easily get in there, put that that effect on it, and then what happens is, only takes a couple of minutes really, and that's where you get this effect right here. So as you can see, it's definitely well worth the investment. There are all sorts of different things we can do for it to really help decorate or give all of our pieces a nice little decorative touch to them. So anyways, though, I think that's pretty much going to do it. Once again, I want to thank the great folks over at Woodcraft and Whiteside Machine Company for being so generous as to donate these router bits. They've decided, you know what, they've gotten some great results with it, and they've heard from so many of you that they're going to continue it for the rest of the year. So that means that there's 12 of you out there that are going to have a chance to win some great router bits. But you know what? I got some great news also. And since January is, well, it's our birthday month here at Matt's Basement Workshop Podcast. In fact, January 26th is our official second anniversary. Well, Whiteside Machine Company sent us a little something special to help celebrate it. And you know what? I'm going to go grab it. And when I grab that, I'm going to come back and I'm also going to tell you who this week's lucky winner is of the great 90 degree Vee Groove cutting bit. And I'm going to show you a little something for when the birthday does roll around that one of you has a great chance of winning. So to help make the second birthday of Matt's Basement Workshop Podcast just way more spectacular, I need to thank Clark, Chris, and Gail over at Whiteside Machine Company for sending us this. This is the router bit set that I've been talking about in the audio podcast. Now, if you haven't heard it, since the second birthday is just around the corner, the great folks over at Whiteside Machine Company, like I said, Clark, Chris, and Gail, thank you so much for sending us the 7-piece set to give away to one of you lucky listeners. Now, this is going to be part of the grand prize package for one of you lucky listeners. If you've gotten your name in right now, then you are all set. You're ready for the possible drawing. I'm going to have a few other things. I've got a couple of packages that I'm going to send out. But if you haven't done already, drop me a line at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com or head over to the website at mattsbasementworkshop.com. Get your name entered for the free swag. You'll have a chance to win this along with a few other things. And, of course, you'll always have a chance to win some great swag at the end of the week. Just like Mike Strube, who won this month's router bit of the month. So congratulations, Mike. You have won the 90-degree V-groove cutting bit from Whiteside Machine Company of Woodcraft. I'll make sure I get a hold of you, get your address and everything so I can send it out. And as always, if you have comments, questions, suggestions, remember, it's the beginning of a new year. Get those the feedback in. Get those questions, the comments, whatever you have. Just, you know what, drop me a line at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com. And that's also where you can enter for the great swag, like, you know, this 7-piece router bit set. So, as always, thanks for stopping by. I really, really appreciate it. It's because of all of you that we've been able to do this for 2 years now. And you know what? I've had an absolute blast the whole entire time. So thank you for being the great listeners and viewers that you are. And until the next time, I'll be talking to you. Straight grains and sharp blades.